Hey guys, Kevin Francisco here from Yugatech.com, and today we'll be taking a look at the Samsung Galaxy S8 Plus. If you've read our Galaxy S8 review, you'd already know that the S8 Plus is not that different compared to the S8. The only difference between the two, aside from the dimensions and weight, is the display size and battery capacity. If you like the size and form factor of the Galaxy Note 7 or the Galaxy S7 Edge, then the Galaxy S8 Plus should be perfect for you. Samsung has made the dual curve design the new standard for its flagship devices, so we're looking at this signature moving forward. The Galaxy S8 Plus features a curved display similar to the execution of the S7 Edge and the late Note 7. As expected, because of the all-glass exterior, the S8 Plus is very slippery to hold and a smudge magnet all around. It still has a slim profile and can be comfortably held with one hand, although you'll tend to use both hands on certain occasions, suggesting that a case is definitely needed here. Samsung managed to dramatically increase the screen size by putting everything else at the back. No more physical home button, just capacitive keys. There's also no more space for the Samsung logo. They trimmed down the bezels on all sides, only leaving a little space for the front camera, sensors, and an iris scanner. The Galaxy S8 Plus has an IP68 rating for dust and water resistance of up to 1.5 meters and 30 minutes. The power button is placed on the right side while the volume controls are on the left with the dedicated Bixby button just below it. At the bottom end is the USB Type-C charging port, 3.5mm audio port, primary microphone, and the speaker grille. At the back is the main 12-megapixel camera with the dual-tone, dual-LED flash on the left and the fingerprint sensor on the right side. For a device that's only the size of the Galaxy S7 Edge or the Note 7, the Galaxy S8 Plus managed to squeeze in a lot more space for the screen. The biggest feature of the Galaxy S8 Plus is its massive display. Measuring 6.2 inches across, the expansive curved display looks really awesome. This also puts the screen-to-body ratio a little over 83%. The S8 Plus features a large screen resolution of 2960 by 1440 pixels, giving it a density of 568 ppi. The resolution can be natively adjusted though, with options for Full HD Plus and HD Plus, depending on user preference. The always-on display has been enhanced to support more notifications, including the capacitive home key. It has also been certified with Mobile HDR Premium by the UHD Alliance, which means it can reproduce better and more vibrant colors, as well as support for streaming services like Amazon and Netflix for their 4K HDR titles. The screen is very bright, crisp, and viewable even under direct sunlight, although it can be very reflective at certain angles. The S8 Plus came with an AKG earphones out of the box. This premium earphones added to the quality of the audio. From the speaker grille, sound is loud, clean, and crisp, with just a little bit of noticeable distortion at maximum volume. There's not much bass or oomph, but it's got a pretty wide range. While the rear camera of the Galaxy S8 Plus still has the same 12-megapixel sensor with the large f1.7 aperture, the module used is a new one. Our review unit uses a Samsung ISOCELL sensor, which might have come with some incremental upgrades from the previous ISOCELL sensor in the Galaxy S7. Here are some sample photos we took, and while we know it's a new sensor, we could not really see anything that improved over the previous one. Video recording is up to 4K at 30fps or 1080p at 60fps. Slow motion video default is at 720p at 240fps. The Galaxy S8 Plus uses a second generation custom Exynos chip, which is a slight upgrade to the previous one they used in the S7. The Exynos 8895 is composed of a power-efficient Cortex A53 quad-core processor running at max speed of 1.7 GHz paired with a high-performance Exynos M1 quad-core processor running a top clock speed of 2.3 GHz. Based on synthetic benchmarks, the Exynos M1 processor did not disappoint, scoring an impressive 175,000 in our AnTuTu benchmark. The score of the Galaxy S8 Plus puts it at the top of the rankings among Android smartphones. It was only beaten by the iPhone 7 due to the HD-only screen of the iOS device. Suffice to say, the Galaxy S8 Plus is a beast in the performance department. It's fast, responsive, and snappy, gobbling up anything we threw at it and breezed through multiple tasks in the background. The Galaxy S8 Plus packs a 3,500 mAh non-removable lithium-ion battery. That's the same capacity as the Note 7, but slightly smaller than the 3,600 mAh capacity of the Galaxy S7 Edge. Nevertheless, Samsung claims it still has the same battery life despite the much larger display, mostly due to the optimizations brought by the Exynos 8895 chip. Using our standard battery benchmark, the Galaxy S8 Plus got 10 hours and 23 minutes with PCMark battery test. That's the same result we got on the Galaxy Note 7 and slightly better than the 9 hours and 50 minutes of the S7 Edge. Using our video loop test, the S8 Plus lasted a little over 18 hours on a full charge playing a full HD movie at 50% brightness, 0% volume, and in airplane mode. That's a full 4 hours better than what the Galaxy S7 Edge got on the same test. The S8 Plus supports fast wired and wireless charging and can recharge to full capacity in around 80 minutes. With a suggested retail price of 45,990 pesos, the Galaxy S8 Plus is pushing the limits of their customers' pockets, but then again, it's a beautiful and powerful device. After two generations, Samsung has made a major design change to the flagship Galaxy S series, and the Galaxy S8 Plus has already made it to the very edge of an immersive smartphone experience. It's got everything you'd want in a flagship smartphone and a little bit more. Once again, this has been Kevin Francisco, and thanks for watching. See you guys next time.